Hello, my name is Edwin Johnson, and welcome to episode 3 of Collection Closeup. What I'd like to do is introduce you to a Kayenga mask that is used by the Suku and the Yaka people of the Democratic Republic of Congo. Now, this mask is very complicated because it is both designed to be frightening and also reassuring all at the same time. Now, these types of masks are used for initiation. Now, the type of initiation that this is used for is for taking youngsters who are, when they're prepubescent and also early adolescents, taking them and turning them into adults. And so what they learn in this process are the responsibilities and the type of initiation process that these initiates go through is one that is a combination of intimidation and also education. Now, the role that this mask plays is very similar to that of the archetypical drill instructor, who is a combination of frightening and also reassuring and protective. And let me show you the different signs on this mask. Now, now as you can see, half the mask is painted red, half the mask is painted white. And this is designed to show the multiple facets of this type of mask and this type of masquerade. Now, the red is meant to be frightening, it's meant to be intimidating, and then on the flip side, the white is designed to be reassuring and relate to healing. And so this rather complex function of this mask is already being clearly displayed in the colors that are painted on the mask, and the fact that these masks are painted one side in one color, one side in the other color, is meant to show this dual type of duty that these masks are supposed to serve. And so, for instance, when are these masks used during the initiation? Well, it's used for three parts of the initiation, and if you really think about it, maybe even a fourth part. Now, the first part of the initiation that this mask plays a role in is introduction. So this mask is used to set the tone for the initiation. Now, the person who is actually using this mask is often an herbalist and somebody who is learned in herbs and healing, and is somebody who is perfectly trained to look after the health and wellness of the initiates. Other times that this mask is used during the initiation process includes circumcision, and also during the time when the initiation process comes to an end. Now, this is when the fact that these masqueraders are also healers comes into great effect. Because for instance, if an initiate should hemorrhage during the circumcision process, what you have behind the mask is somebody who could heal and who could solve that problem right on the spot. The other purpose of the mask is to actually bring the initiation process to a state of closure. So this mask is used during the introduction, circumcision, and closure. And I mentioned that there could be four purposes for this mask and four points that, where this mask is being used. Well, the fourth is also part of the closure process, and what it is that this mask is used during the time when food taboos are being lifted, and during the closure process, and that is considered a very significant part of the closure process. So that could almost come into its own state of being a fourth purpose for the mask. Now, what these masks are generally representing is the health and well-being of society, both through a little bit of intimidation, but also through a lot of care. And so, when we're looking at masks like this, even though it may seem like a very intimidating type of mask. I mean, when I see people walking through this gallery, they come upon this mask and they're just like, wow, look at this thing. And it isn't just because it's big, it's just because it is. It is a rather intimidating mask. But that's only part of the story. And the fact that something like this would not only be seen as intimidating, but also reassuring, in a healing way, in a spiritual way. So this type of mask serves quite a number of functions that go beyond just its initial shock factor. So there are many masks in this collection that are easily misunderstood. And what I'm going to do is introduce you in the future during collection close-ups are other masks that may seem a little bit intimidating, even a little bit off-putting, but actually are used in order to reassure and to maintain the well-being of a community. So until next time, goodbye. And if you'd like to see more of our videos, please like and subscribe to our YouTube channel.